The story we brought you yesterday about a Hamilton County deputy's eviction was just the tip of the iceberg. Good evening, I'm Calvin Snead.
I'm Kim Chapman. During Deputy Donnie Myrick's eviction, other deputies found confidential case files and weed. News Channel 9's Kelsey Bagwell tells us more. Kelsey.
Kim, Calvin, Deputy Myrick's eviction only scratches the surface in a string of controversies. Today, we learned his former canine partner, Falco, came to live with Myrick after he retired. But soon after, Falco was seized by the Humane Educational Society for neglect.
Friday, family members are picking up the pieces of their lives, unceremoniously dumped in a dispute between renter and landlord, both Hamilton County Sheriff's deputies. Discoveries of case files and a small amount of marijuana during Deputy Donnie Myrick's eviction sparked an internal investigation. But Myrick and his family weren't the only ones who called this North Dent Road house their home.
There's food over there and water. This doghouse is broken. I don't think that rug is keeping much of that water out either. There's feces all over his pants, and the water's dirty too.
10-year-old Falco retired from the sheriff's office in March and came to live with Myrick, his former handler. Last month, the Humane Educational Society seized the dog after concerned neighbors complained Myrick may have moved out, leaving the dog behind. When Myrick learned Falco had been seized, he surrendered him to the shelter. But it wasn't always this way. Here's a look at Myrick and Falco working a car theft in 2010. How far they seem to have come.
It broke my heart.
Robin Scott is the founder of Invest in K9, an effort to provide every canine with a bulletproof vest. She raised enough money to buy one for Falco last year.
Once I vest the dog, there's a lot of joy that comes out of it because I know that dog's protected. And to hear that that dog was not protected at home is very disappointing.
Myrick is on paid administrative leave pending the outcome of the investigation, but things are looking up for the retired canine.
We are very fortunate, and it's a happy ending for Falco because he's going to live his life out now like he should.
As for Falco's new home, a police canine trainer adopted him from the shelter. Kim.
All right, Kelsey, thank you very much.